your papa!
Okay, sitting right across me, we have Beyoncé.
Thank you. Yes, I am.
People don't know that whether you are truly Beyoncé or not because we are doing an audio. So,
hello, hi, I'm Beyoncé. I'm a single ladies.
Okay, very very excited to have you. Not Beyoncé, but Munah in my podcast.
Now everyone's disappointed. Everyone's like, oh, okay, Munah ni.
She came bearing gifts.
Yes, I did.
She brought Doritos. And then she brought Doritos and other junk food. And I told her that I actually don't eat.
I should have known, right? Because he's like a fighter. He's fit. But I thought you can just eat it during your cheat day, okay?
You say fighter, my friends are cringing and their eyes are rolling back now.
Okay.
I really appreciate you coming all the way to see me to
no,
to do
of
the
course.
Podcast. Because we are very new. We don't have a big following yet. Mm-hmm. You know, to me, like, this opens a lot of doors for me. Because now if like local celebrities see my Instagram page, oh, you got to do with Munah, then they'll be more comfortable to do it with me.
I hope so. Don't put your expectations up too high. But no, I'm really happy to be here. I'm always very supportive of people who have great new ideas, who are creative. And yeah, I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
Okay, and this is your second podcast?
Yes. I know kind of how podcasts work, but I guess we're just talking.
It's basically interviews, right. But just, you know, with no cameras.
I'm still quite noob lah with podcasts,
okay? Yeah, so
podcast,
you can actually, we can lie down on the floor.
But okay. They won't know,
yeah. We do push-up, you know. people won't know. Okay, so Hirzi is not in Singapore?
He is away in Vietnam at the moment. He's doing a styling job. Shout out to Hirzi, what's up?
What's the...
In Vietnam.
How do you say hello in Vietnam?
I don't know. Okay. Hello.
Well, what is Hirzi doing right now? He's
Well, actually, we both are really busy preparing for our closing show in January.
That's right.
Yeah, I know. So it's been a lot of stuff on our mind, but rehearsals are starting soon. But at the same time, we're also handling like getting the music arrangement down, getting like all the setting of the stage down. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's our life.
So
for
how
this
can
moment.
People get tickets to watch your
Aha,
show?
Tickets will be out on PTX. Mm-hmm. Or tickets are out on PTX, depending on where you put this up.
PTX
is like Sistic, but it's a different like ticketing platform. So it's on PTX. And yeah, I think it's going to be quite exciting. It's happening on 24th January at Capitol Theatre. So woohoo!
You've guys come a long way from your channel, right? From creating your channel. And he's doing his own thing. Mm-hmm. You are doing your own thing. What are you currently doing right now?
what am I doing in my life, right?
What is your own thing?
Well, I've always been acting and hosting. That's on the side. But lately, I've gotten deeper into the world of theatre. It's really, I think, where my true passion is and where I want to try and grow. So over the last 2 or 3 years, I've been doing a lot of stage shows, mm-hmm. be it like narrative performances or just like concert performances, but anything to do with theatre, which is what I love. And I think after Munah Hirzi Official, so I want to try and pursue that, not only in the acting realm of things, but also in the producing realm of things. So like, you know, I get a more holistic experience, altogether. Yeah.
You do emceeing, and were you a host for a channel?
Well, I host different things, basically, like events, TV shows, concerts, festivals. Mm.
Basically, you're an MC as well.
There's
a lot of competition for that, right, MCs? Like,
I don't know if it's a competition, but it still is a big market because there's always, like, events happening, there's always TV shows happening, but... It's fun lah, I think, because it's very live, and I think that's also what I love about theatre, is that it's live and you kind of get it's like you feel the energy of the audience, and I always love things to do with that.
A whole different thing compared when you're doing your YouTube. Let's talk about the YouTube channel first.
Okay,
how did that came about? How do you know Hirzi?
Oh my god, so I met Hirzi when I first joined Poly, so we were both in the same course. Temasek Poly. You from SP, is it?
No, I'm from RP. A lot of my friends are from, sorry,
Singapore Volley. Oh, TP. Yeah, TP. Oi. TP. Oi. At this point of time. All the TPNs must get sub, sub. Oi.
Everybody in TP right now better subscribe to
exactly. Do it. Okay. TP Pride. But yeah, so we met each other in Temasek Poly. And we've been friends since then. But how the YouTube channel started was because we were always doing like crazy, stupid things in school. Mm-hmm. We were disturbing people. We were like, camera should be on us all the time. Mm-hmm. And closer to graduation, because our modules in what we were studying, which was like communications and media, needed us to, you know, like shoot like short films or whatever. So we kind of got a bit savvier with like camera work ish mm-hmm. lah, not like super savvy. Now all the DPs that work with us like, no, y'all are bad. But you know, like we knew how to work a camera, and we thought like, oh, okay, yeah, just enough. So we started doing stuff, and when we first started doing it, we wanted to just do it for fun. Mm-hmm. Wanted to share it among our friends. But what happened was that when we uploaded stuff on YouTube, YouTube was like a growing medium at that time. Mm-hmm. And other people started to watch also. So they were like, do more, do more. We're like, who are these people watching our videos?
There were not a lot of YouTube.
Yeah, exactly. It
you
was
guys are probably the pioneers of Singapore.
Thanks.
YouTubing.
We believe lah. There's also like, at that point of time, there were, when it was growing, there was also like people like, there were people like Dikosh, Xia Shui also was blogging at that time, but she was going into like another part of social media. So there were these few people, but it wasn't as big as what it is now. Like now people go onto social media for like business. Mm-hmm. It's a different it's a different purpose altogether. Exactly, which is great lah.
I actually thought from your chemistry with Hirzi, you guys are like childhood friends. Like you know, kindergarten, and you go to the same kindergarten.
Yeah, that's no, what no, that's what some
chemistry
people think.
That you guys have is, you know, is you guys are so close.
Oh yeah, yeah, I think
it surprises me that you guys know each other only in poly.
Oh really?
Yeah,
oh
okay. I barely hang out with my poly friends.
Right.
You know, I
you forgot them, right?
I forgot them. Yeah, but you see? But through Instagram, I like their photos.
Mm-hmm, sure. That's all your friendship is. But yeah, I mean, Hirzi and I had a different sort of special connection. Like when we met, we instantly clicked, and it's like, you know, like sometimes you meet people and you feel like you've known them for years already.
Yeah.
And it feels that way with Hirzi. And I think that's why we have such great chemistry working together and being friends lah.
So when you guys started, what was the content of your YouTube channel about?
It was really just like slapstick kind of humor. I mean, we the series that really like took off when we first started was 10 Dares, where we like went around to do like crazy things and and disturb people but then at one point of time someone like commented and said like, ala, these kids, they only good for like this stupid kind of humor. They can never do real humor. Then we like, ha, we'll take that as a challenge. So we started Sex Appeal and Jokes, which was kind of like we talk to camera and then there are little skits, but we tackle issues that are important in society but with humor. And that's how we started to grow in the quality of our production and content as well. Like we put out more videos with messages, and we use comedy as like a medium, I suppose, to like put out these messages in a very lighthearted way, but it still hits you and it still makes you understand like what's crucial in the society.
But at that point, you guys haven't have your, you know, personas yet, right? Like the
characters, is it?
Yeah, yeah. Like, how did that evolve?
I don't even know. Actually, like, I think a bit before Sex Appeal and Jokes, we already had, like, some of the characters. That's why in the first one, there were a few different characters who evolved, but I think they also came up during Sex Appeal and Jokes, because when we were doing up the skits and we were thinking like, okay, what would be good for this, like these characters started to form. One of my favorite characters who are like very prominent and now people only know us as those characters are the Epic Minas. They have helmed our YouTube channel for the last like 3 years, I would say, with their parodies.
Easier to
I think the Minas came like because they were such like rebellions, and they were like an alter ego of Hirzi and I, and it was so strong to put across like messages through them, because you know like Minas are usually just like, okay, Mina, like no one really cares about them, but there are these two Minas who like are standing up for like things that are important, and I think people can also relate to them because they're very like They're like you and I lah. Mm. I mean, unless okay, maybe you're not a mat lah, but I'm a Mina at heart.
I don't play soccer. I don't play guitar. I really don't know. My friends say that I'm like the worst representation of a Malay.
Oh my god! Yeah, where is your guitar? You see lah, don't even have.
When I box, I do stand in the corner lah.
Okay. Then at least there's that. But yeah. So there's always a Mina in everyone.
Would you agree that having a character, you can get away with a lot of things? Like for example, when you do a lot of shenanigans in public.
Yeah.
Right? So you know if people. I mean, of course, when they see you, oh, that's Munah. Yeah. But you know, you are in character.
Yeah.
You are that character. Or when Hirzi is, what's her mate?
Latisha Shah. Yeah, Latisha Shah.
Latisha Shah, yeah. So when he's Latisha Shah, people immediately with the outfit and all that. Yeah, so people identify with that. You guys can get away with a lot of stuff.
It's actually true to a certain extent, macam social studies. But it's true. Like sometimes because Hirzi and I like we feel so much for these characters. Sometimes when we are these characters, like they completely take over and we don't even consciously choose what the characters do. I don't know if you understand saying. I guess. And then sometimes you just forget. And sometimes when we do stuff, we always like joke and we say like, sorry, it's the Mina in me. Or like, sorry, it's the character, it's the Shah. So I guess in a way you can kind of get away with it because at the end of the day, you are playing a role. And this character is a certain way, is you know, wants to behave a certain way. And that's just how it is.
What's the most silliest, memorable thing that you've done in public?
God, I don't even know. We do so many crazy things. I don't know.
We do a lot of people in public.
We do. MRTs, I mean, we basically just create a ruckus, like shout at people.
They know who you are, right? Like, most people.
I don't know. Maybe. Actually, some people, like, when we disturb them, right, then after a while, like, they'll be like, oh, Munah, here's it. And then they play along, which is always fun. But, like, of course, we always try and find the people who, like, don't know what's happening and we can scare them. But I think one of the scariest things I had to do was in 10 days where I had to crash a lecture. There was, like, a video long time ago. But
I remember this.
Yeah, so, like, that was really scary. Like, when I had to do it, I was genuinely scared because the lecturer, as the people said, was very strict. So, I didn't know how he was gonna handle it, but actually he was okay. He wasn't so bad. But I was just like, my heart was beating so fast right before doing that.
At least 10 days, right?
Yeah lah. You have to do the dare. You cannot say no.
You have to do something daring.
Exactly.
When was the last time you actually uploaded something? I remember that you posted. Hirzi was singing the national anthem, and then you was like, yak your bapa.
Our last sex appeal and jokes.
Can I use that as a soundbite for the start?
Do it. Yeah, your bapa. That's Cathy for you. See, again, I have no control. Cathy just went there, so it's her fault, whatever it is. But yeah, that was our last sex appeal and jokes because we are in our last year now. So all the videos that we're creating are the last of like a series last. So we have the last sex appeal and jokes, and then all our characters have like last music parody. So they're all gonna come out like towards the end of the year, which is now basically.
What happened to Hubab?
Hubab, well, he's busy. Hubab and Nadiah were a big part of our channel, but I think everyone kind of got busy with their own lives. Yeah. Like he's now working, and he's doing well. We actually just saw them recently before Nadiah gave birth. Nadiah gave birth already! So cute, so handsome, the baby boy. Okay. His name is Nahyan, and he's so handsome, but. With Hubab and Hadiah, I think they Hadiah pula. Hadiah siapa? With Hubab and yeah, exactly. With Hubab and Nadiah, I think they also at some point of time had their own priorities that they wanted to achieve, and we were like, yeah, okay, of course, sure. But we still keep in touch and we still do stuff. Especially this year, it was very nice because we haven't seen each other in so long. But they did like the epic Mina reunion with us for our Hari Raya video, and that was just so much fun to shoot.
And you guys come back every Raya to do a music video as
yes
well, right?
Except next year no more.
Next year no more. Why?
Because last year already, what? No more.
One of the questions that I've had was always like, why is it not like Munah Hubab
No. Nadia. Well, no, actually, because it started when we first started, it was just Hirzi and I, and like I don't know why we thought of that name, but we thought, okay, the name we never planned it, okay, because we never planned on this being anything, so it just became Munah Hirzi official. But for a good cause. But Hubab only joined us. We only met Hubab like halfway through, like maybe 2 years in or a year in, and then we became friends. No, we met him through like a friend. And then like he started watching us, and he was like, oh okay, I guess he thought we were quite entertaining. We started hanging out, and he was like, oh, I want to be part of it. We're like, okay, sure.
Is Hood really his real name?
Yes, Hubab Hood. He's partially Arab.
How are you so flamboyant and charismatic? In a sense, you are not afraid to be very vocal in public, and you know, interact with the disturbed people,
I don't know. I think I just like I was born this way. No, I don't know. I guess it's just that I like to laugh. Like like humor is a big part of me. As I was growing up, I love to like do crazy things,
you're
do funny things.
An extrovert.
I don't know. Maybe. But when I met Hirzi, I think that's when I was like, oh my god, there's someone else who like understands like my humor and understands like what I like to do and how annoying I can be. And like the fact that we are able to do all those crazy things, I think it's also like because I know once I do the crazy things, I have Hirzi to run back to. You know what I mean? It's like kind of like a support system of sorts. So I think that kind of pushes us also, and like, okay, we're confident enough to do these fun things.
I somehow feel like you are like the noisy kid in class. Like in
secondary school. What?
Like you're always getting singled out by your teacher.
Hey, no, okay. No, what happens is that, and my friends will vouch for this, every time, like, I am the noisy one, but I was a good student, okay? I always, like...
A student.
Yeah, okay? I was very good. I like to study. But what happened is that because, like, I'm the so-called good student, right? I will answer questions. I'm, like, the teacher's pet. Every time, like, I somehow make noise, the teachers will immediately think it's my other friends. And then they will get, like, scolded. They were like, yo, why you make noise? And then I'm just like... Oh my god.
Because people wouldn't think it's
exactly. Yeah. So I get away with it. My friends get trouble.
Very strategic. Wow, okay.
So that's the advice. A lot, no, a lot of teachers. Okay. I'm not gonna name names in case you find them.
Okay. Would you change anything given a chance you can go back to your channel?
No, I don't think I would. I mean, we it's been a long run, 10 years, and I think we went through a lot of stuff, like good and bad. But I wouldn't change a thing because everything that happened or every obstacle that came helped us, like helped build us to where we are today and helped us grow. I would.
Whether good or bad, you wouldn't be who you are today without.
Exactly. True that.
True that. When do you feel that you guys gain some sort of notoriety? I always have trouble saying this word. Notoriety.
Oh, notoriety. Notoriety. Wow, what a big word.
When did it came a point where you guys in public and people, oh, it's Munah. Oh, it's
Hirzi. Oh, my God.
People want to take selfies with you.
I never thought of that. I don't know.
What was it during the early years?
Probably, maybe... I don't know. I can't put a time. I want to just anyhow and say one and a half years in.
Back then you were still poly students, right?
We were just graduating. So it's right after graduation then we started like to go full on with this.
I was thinking that wouldn't you guys have a hard time getting unnoticed in school?
Well, we were always like notorious in school also. We would like do crazy things. Sometimes we meet like TP people now and they were like, oh, we know you. You were the noisy kids in school. We're like, yeah, that's who we are. But I actually don't know. Maybe I want to say maybe 1 year in plus or 1.5 years when it started. Yeah, probably. Then again, I'm just guessing. So,
okay, but I mean, right now, it's almost impossible not to get noticed, right?
Such a weird thing to say, but yeah, lah. I mean, it's nice to meet people, lah. I think because we do so much stuff online that we don't always get to see who's following us or you know, like the people who like interacting with us. So it's nice when like you get to meet them and take photos and kind of talk to them and stuff like that. So it's fun.
How do you get a picture with the Backstreet Boys?
Oh my god.
You're posting things like, oh, AJ is my husband.
I'm getting married. Because you too slow, okay? AJ asked me already and I was like, yes, AJ, of course. already married. That day was my wedding. The performance. Like, you don't know. But because I'm such a big fan of the Backstreet Boys. Sorry, I'm shouting now. Luckily, no one here. So I'm such a huge fan of the Backstreet Boys, and I always go every time they're in Singapore. Only 1 year I didn't go, okay, because I was busy, and then tickets were sold out when I wasn't. But every year I would go, like, if they come, and this time round they had VIP tickets to meet, so obviously I got it lah.
You know, earlier that day, before their concert, I had this prank that I wanted to do. I posted on Facebook. Oh my god, I took a picture with the Backstreet Boys, but it's in my SD card. I can't wait to go home and post it.
Oh my god!
So for some reason, that post got a lot of likes.
Really?
What I wanted to do at the end of the day was like take a picture of the Backstreet Boys on my laptop and then hold it, and then I got a picture with the Backstreet Boys.
But so irritating.
And then I forgot to do that as well.
Like, what?
And then when I came back to work, people was like, "So where's the picture? Where's the picture?"
Oh no! And then what do you show them?
I'm not. Those kind of people, they like to post my personal life online.
So now you all know it's a lie, okay, guys? He was tricking you.
I saw that you took pictures with Backstreet Boys, and you were so shy.
Yeah! Oh my god, I didn't know how to act. Like, when I saw them, I was so nervous, and the bodyguard who was, like, waiting, like, you will wait with the bodyguard before you take a photo, then he was like, okay, just breathe. You walk over to Brian, you hug AJ, and then you stand in the middle for a photo. I'm like, okay.
Is it because you bought VIP tickets? Or?
Yes, so they had the VIP super fan tickets.
Because you had like connections, like, you know,
it was like that. No, yeah, it's not that easy. Life is hard. But no, if anyone have any connections to the Backstreet Boys, just let me know. Although I am married to AJ, yes, but you know,
still
just
got 4 months.
Yeah, still got 4 months.
That's not for you. That's for AJ.
No, it's for me.
Are you an NSYNC fan as well?
No. I hate NSYNC, okay, like, I'm okay with them, but like at that point of time when I was such a huge fan of BSB, I was like, I am against NSYNC because they were rivals, kan.
So we know that the channel has bought a lot of positive opportunities for you.
Mm-hmm.
What about negative?
Well, I mean, with everything also, there's always going to be haters. Haters going to hate.
Haters
but
hate.
Yeah, I mean, there were difficult times when we first got like the first wave of hate that we experienced was when we were having that drama on Surya. And I think what people misunderstood was that whatever we were going to do on our channel, which was all the crazy stuff, was going to be brought onto like the Malay channel. And I think people were just unhappy about that. I mean, like,
or the Surya
channel. Yeah, like that
was the show called
Munah and Hirzi Action, something like that, or Live. No, that's my show.
Your own show. That's a big thing. If I was you, I'd be like so excited.
I mean,
the Farikin show.
The Farikin show. But yeah, so that happened, and I think we live and we learn, like. It was scary for us because it was the first time it ever happened, and it was really about dealing with the hate and
online.
Yeah, online. And what's good is that I had Hirzi with me, so like the
support
two
system.
Of us, yeah, yeah. There was a support system, and we really learned from there. I mean, there was criticism that was helpful, and there was criticism that was just noise, and I've learned that that's how you separate it. If something like someone tells you something bad about you and it's something that's gonna help you, take it, you know, like, because that's how you grow.
Yeah.
But if it's just like lame, stupid, idiots, you know, like, it's just noise. Like, you're not gonna get help with any of those comments. But then over the years, when there were like different obstacles, different haters, I think we kind of got better at dealing with it. The main thing is to just focus on what you believe in, and focus on what your supporters want and what your supporters think of you. Like, I think that's the best part, to stay positive.
Do you get depressed the first time it happened?
I wouldn't say depressed, but I was a little like startled.
Affected.
I would say, yeah, and affected, because it's just like, oh my god, what is happening? And I was so young then, you know, like, and you're just like, what is happening?
How old were you?
19. Maybe 20-ish.
You started your
early
channel?
Early 20s. We started our channel at 18, 19, okay. That sort of thing.
Can go zook.
I was young, like, you know, you still had that like mentality, and it was definitely something like a shocker when it comes to you. But I had a great support system. My family, my friends were so helpful.
Your parents were very supportive?
Yeah, my parents were actually very supportive. I think like what my dad said was like, it doesn't matter what the public thinks of you, you know, like, it won't change whatever they think of me, and they know like why I'm doing certain things that I choose to do. And to me, that's the most important thing. If my like inner circle are supportive of me and are okay, then I know that you know it's something good. Because I know at the end of the day, if I'm doing something horrible, they will tell me also. They will be the ones telling me like, stop Munah, you're too much, you know. So I trust them.
Put you on a leash.
Yeah. So, stop it.
Having said that, what do you think is the public perception of you?
I actually think the public thinks I am, I don't know. Actually, I don't know what you all think of me, but I know. Okay.
You got so many characters. You got the Munah
character. Like something's not
like
right.
A politician.
Oh, so that's what you think of me. Like something's wrong with.
But Hirzi has exponentially more characters.
Yeah, yeah, he does. He's a bit more like weirder than me.
Yeah, does all his characters wear short pants? Is that just something like his?
Oh my god, I never realized that. I think so.
Right, he got no long pants character.
No, they're all short pants.
Idea, is it long pants character?
Oh my god, that's so funny. But I don't know what the public thinks of me. But I know there are people who like think like I'm. I don't know, like outgoing. I don't know, like okay, but whatever it is, right? I'm actually damn boring, okay, in person. Like I don't like to club. I don't drink. I don't smoke. No, people always think like I'm like party girl. I'm actually damn boring, guys.
You're straight edge like me. Yeah, I don't like me lah.
Yeah.
I also don't smoke. I don't drink.
Club. And I just like to sit at home, go Mustafa Center, MTUC. I really love to do that.
What do you like to eat at Mustafa Center?
I like to eat. You know, there's the one level where they got the pizza. Like the instant pizza. Oh my god, I love that so much. And the garlic bread.
Yeah, it's, and everything that is cheap too.
Yes.
Speaking of pizza, you've been to Rome, right? Or Italy?
Apa tu? Oh, yeah. No, apa I've tu? Never been to.
What? Rome.
Clearly, I have not. Okay. No, I have never been to Rome, but I was recently in Milan.
Yeah, I went to Rome once and
nice.
I saw the pizza, so many different varieties.
Yeah.
Prawn pizza. That's right. You would even dream.
Oh
of
my god, are you serious?
To be in a topping on a pizza.
Oh, actually, when I went to Italy, I didn't get to try pizza, but I tried like spaghetti, which is nice.
So apparently, according to Munah, she's a very boring person.
I am. Okay, guys, don't expect too much from me. I'm boring.
Keep your expectations low when you meet her. Was it challenging keeping up with the channel?
Yes, I would say.
I imagine right now you have a better crew to work with, right?
Yeah.
You know, better equipments and, you know, production value has gone up.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm glad you noticed.
Hollywood. As a videographer myself, I was actually very impressed for a casual, non-media.
Yeah, but it got effort. You know, got effort.
A for effort. You know?
Oh, thank you. Yeah. That really means a lot. But yeah, I think over the years also, because we started working with like clients and brands, we wanted to provide them with like better quality. I think it's only right because they're paying for like a certain kind of
sponsorship.
Yeah, like they're just paying for like a product or like a video campaign, and I feel it's only right that we do our part and put in effort lah. So but it also opened doors for us to work with like these camera people, these crew people, these DPs who are just amazing in their work. And what Hirzi and I like to do is like with the people we work with, we don't like tell them like, okay, we want this, we let them like suggest like, what's your idea, what do you think will be best, because we obviously trust them. And the kind of work that we create together as a team has been great lah. So we're very fortunate to have met all these people. Shout out to all the crew boys. And girls who have been part of our productions.
What's your most favourite skit that you've done?
Wow, favourite skit I can't. Oh, how to choose. I wouldn't say skit, but one of my favorite like music parodies or videos that we've done is Formation by Beyoncé. I think that one meant a lot because Hirzi and I were addressing things that has happened to us, like, you know, recent to that time. And at the same time, we're also featuring like these strong, empowered personalities in Singapore. So we had like our friends, we had people that we've always looked up to, part of the video. And I think that one held a very, very strong message for all of us lah.
Who writes the lyrics for
Hirzi? Hirzi is great. Oh my god, he's like so quick to come up with lyrics. I don't even know how he does it. Sometimes like we're in the car and like we're just listening to the song, then he like changes the song. I'm like, oh my god, that's such a great parody, let's do something like that. And he'll be like, okay. It's been fun. But now Pretty Please is also doing parodies and I'm very excited. Please. Pretty Please, come on, you know Pretty Please.
Pretty Please, come do my podcast.
Yes, Pretty Please, do the podcast. So she's great also. I love that she's starting to do this. She's creative. I love her to bits. Like ever since she came out, I'm just like, this girl, she's gonna go far. So I love her. And do this podcast, okay?
Gun to the head, who oh could my replace Hirzi?
Oh my god. Okay, the first person that the first person that comes to mind is Hubab. You know why? Because Hubab and I always have this running joke that like when we're shooting together, right, he will like take out his phone. He's like, "Hi, please subscribe to Munah Hubab Official," and we you know, just like snap. And then we always joke with Hirzi like, "Yeah, sorry Hirzi, we're gonna kick you out. We're gonna make it Hubab, Munah Hubab Official." And there was a point of time where people thought Hubab and I were dating, and then like we just like went with it. Like we're like, "Yeah, sorry guys, we're gonna get rid of Hirzi. It's gonna be just the both of us." And people
were
like,
comments people post like, Is Hirzi and Hubab dating?
Munah and Hirzi. Everyone lah. So I don't know. Actually, no one can replace Hirzi. But like when you put me on the spot, it was Hubab because of that joke. But if it was Munah Hubab Official, I don't think. Know what will happen.
Let's make it clear, people. We are three platonic friends.
Yes. Thank you, everyone. We are all platonic.
Okay. What advice would you give to people who wants to start a YouTube channel or like someone like me who started something?
I think at this point of time, it's a great, like social media is a great platform to try out new things. The one thing I always tell people is that do something that is authentic to who you are. So don't try to like create something that you don't feel for, or create something that you don't understand. Like just whatever you are passionate about, whatever you find most interesting, put it out there, and then people who are like-minded will will connect with you. I think that's the most important thing. Just be authentic.
How do you define yourself as a person? You act, MC, you entertain, you
I entertain.
I don't mean to say like that.
I hope I entertain.
Like if you write a form or something, and they say occupation.
Oh my god.
What do you put in your
shit? Usually, you know what? I said shit. But then my internet, right?
Actually, you can cast here.
Cast so much. Shit. What the hell? Anyway, what I would usually put is actor/host. I think that's what I started with, and that's what I have been. Like, that's my so-called day job. Like, everyone asks me, like, what is your day job, actually? I'm like, actor or host.
Freelance.
Yeah,
freelance
sort of. Yeah, actor or host. Yeah. That's
she
what
acts
I would
also.
I do, I
she
do.
She got the thing, acting thing.
Acting thing going on.
Last question, what is next for Munah?
What
would you like to try next?
Wow.
Add to your bucket list. Oh no, not bucket list. You're not gonna die.
Bucket
so
list.
Add to your name card.
Actually, I want to go into. No.
Can be my Munah
co-host. Okay, oh my god, Munah. Excuse me, I have to come first, okay? Munah Farikin Official. Do not click. But I think what I want to go into a bit more was, like I said before, like producing more in the theater segment of things. Just because I'm always a bit interested in that. Like, I want to be more than just like the front. You know, I mean, like, just like acting is one thing, and it's a skill that I definitely want to keep learning and keep improving on. But at the same time, I also want to try like the different side of things so that I get a more holistic understanding of how things work.
Okay.
Foo. Miss Universe answer.
Yeah, you are
world peace.
But you are free to come and be my main host, and I'll be the
guest
host.
Wow. What? Then it becomes do not click.
Munah Farikin
Official.
Okay, so before we start the podcast, you are very good friends with Benjamin Kheng, right?
I would say yes, okay. I think. I don't know.
So me and Benjamin Kheng used to be polymates.
Okay.
And I think once upon a time okay. I think once upon a time he was also my classmate.
Okay.
I can't remember because he doesn't come to class.
Ayo, okay, outed already.
Right. So the reason I'm bringing this up is actually I think he's pissed off with me about something. So long ago we used to be pals.
Okay.
And then this was way before he was famous.
All right.
So I think he had some friends who were doing a video project.
Okay.
And he asked me, "Hey, could you help my friends out doing this video?"
Okay.
And then I did, but I didn't finish the job. So I think that left.
What? Okay.
Sorry. No, but it was to be fair. I was also working at that time. So
okay.
And actually, a lot of it is my fault.
All right.
Okay, so where was I going with this? Okay. Sorry. So basically.
Okay, I'll give you the floor. Come say sorry.
Benjamin Kheng, I'm sorry. hopefully you we can bury the hatchet and water under the bridge.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Good luck with that. This is why, ladies and gentlemen, you must finish the job if you commit to it.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Thank you very much,
okay,
Munah.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for having me.
You are very, very busy running here and there. Yes. Postponed two to three times. But
this is why I came with snacks.
Yeah, to appease my soul.
Yes. Yay. Thank you.
Thank you, Munah.
Thanks for having me.
Bye.
Bye.